fans. Welcome back to Ghost Rider Television. My name is Sean Petka. Well, like I said in the regular season highlights, playoffs were about to begin, and the next 3 weeks would be interesting. Well, I was right. 3 weeks have come and gone, and the ultimate goal was achieved. The boys become, the Ghost Riders, I should say, become AWHL Born Cup champions with hard work and dedication like they brought through the entire year into playoffs. The Ghost Riders were 11 wins, no losses in the playoffs. Grady Hunt had 3 shutout wins. The first series saw the Ghost Riders taking on the Helena Gold Rush. And put it this way, you wanted to see domination, the Riders dominated. Scoring the first game was 5-1 for Riders, the second game was 5-0, and the third game was 6-0. A pretty impressive stat for the first round, and what can you say? End of the regular season, everybody questioned, well, with the 31 straight wins since November and having those 2 losses near the end of the season, could the Riders be overconfident? Well, that wasn't the case, and the boys proved it. So the first highlight reel that you're going to see is against the Helena Gold Rush. In games 1 and 2, the Fernies took out Gold Rush 3 straight in a best of 5. And here's those highlights.
You can see.
That was pretty spectacular. Well, it didn't get any easier, and the Riders had to prove something to everybody in the league. Throughout the history of the AWHL, the Billings Bulls have won 5 championships out of 6 seasons, and that's pretty impressive. They've been to the finals 5 straight years, everybody. And what can you say? It was a dedicated hockey team that had to be taken out by a greater hockey team, which the Ghost Riders did. In a best of 7, Ghost Riders swept the Billings Bulls 4 straight. Scoring in the first game was Riders' 5-1 victory. The second game was a 5-3 victory. The third game was a 4-0 shutout in Billings. And what can you say? To sweep the Billings Bulls, game 4 went into a stunning overtime with the Riders coming back from a 3-1 deficit with Trent Omer getting the game winner. Again, the second series highlights are the Ghost Riders defeating the Bourne Cup champions, Billings Bulls, 4 straight. Watch this.
So let's
Wow. Who better to take out the defending champions than the best team in the league for 99-2000, the Fernie Ghost Riders? Couldn't have any controversy without in this league, and put it this way, the Riders had an uphill battle from right from the beginning with some teams, as well as inside the U.S. Hockey Network, didn't want a Canadian team going to the national championships. The Ghost Riders had to fight adversity all year long, and doesn't matter if it was from the refereeing side of it or certain tactical advantage some teams try to use against us for the finals, which was Great Falls, on a technicality saying that Dave Zimmerich was not eligible to be in the playoffs. Well, the rule was, and how they ruled it down, was kind of bogus, if asked me, and it was a tactical chance that they took in order to have the cup handed to them. It wasn't. We lost Zimmerich for the rest of the playoffs, and the team was fined $5,000. But never say never, and the boys wanted to prove a point. Like the coach for the Great Falls American says, we wanted to settle this on the ice. Well, we did. We proved who the best team was. Fernie was number one in the league, Great Falls was number two, and the only way to settle any type of discussion is on the ice. Again, a best of seven Bourne Cup Finals, Riders sweep the Great Falls Americans in four. The first game, the Riders took a 4-2 win. Second game was a 3-1 win. The third game in Great Falls was a 7-3 victory for the Riders. And what better, for game four, a busload of fans and people that drove down to support the Riders cheered them on. Must have been over 200 to 250 fans from Fernie there screaming and making noise, and got to watch history in the making when the Riders swept the Great Falls Americans to win the Bourne Cup Championships 3-1. Again, these are the highlights, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Stay tuned, because they're dandies. And who better to win the Bourne Cup Championships than the number one ranked team in the AWHL?
Oh, pushing everything beyond the limit. You play the game, you gotta play to win it. So raise your glasses, raise your glasses.
I'm not a lumberjack or a fur trader. And I don't live in an igloo or eat blubber or own a dog sled. And I don't know Jimmy, Sally, or Susie from Canada, although I'm certain they're really, really nice. I have a prime minister, not a president. I speak English and French, not American. And I pronounce it about, not a boot. I can proudly sew my country's flag on my backpack. I believe in peacekeeping, not policing. Diversity, not assimilation. And that the beaver is a truly proud and noble animal. A toque is a hat. A Chesterfield is a coat. And it is pronounced Zed, not Z-Z. Canada is the second largest landmass, the first nation of hockey, and the best part of North America. My name is Joe, and I am Canadian.
Thank you.